If you want a bike that's a bit different and you don't fancy a dodgy European brand, then why not look to the land of the free and the overweight? American bikes certainly are different. Predominantly cruisers suited to the long straight freeways with the butch-looking Buell thrown in for good measure. But do you really want a brash American?
One of the big advantages of American motorcycles is that they are extremely good value for money. Although on the face of it they may look expensive, they're not, because the overall ownership benefits of American motorcycles are absolutely superb.
They stand out in a crowd because everybody has the impression of Easy Rider. They all think about the film and the music, and that just cuts it completely from a sports bike market.
To the non-biking public, and too many bikers for that matter, American bikes mean Harley-Davidson. But now Victory, Boss Hoss and others are competing with the mighty Harley-Davidson and giving the Yanks a bit of variety, although they do all look quite Harley-esque. If you do want the mix of sports bike and street fighter performance, then the Buell is just waiting for you to discover it. And believe me, it corners like a pro.
Performance of American motorcycles has never really been associated with speed. The performance factor is the ability of the motorcycle to carry people and luggage across country with a relative degree of comfort, which all American cycles do extremely well.
Well, if you like having your feet and arms forward greeting the horizon, then I suppose you'll find these bikes comfy. Depends on what you're used to, really. The Buell is another kettle of fish. It's tall and hunched and might be comfy if you're Quasimodo. These bikes are big beasties, especially the Boss Hoss. It's got a V8 in there now. How are you supposed to get that around town, eh? Not exactly nimble or practical, is it?
They are practical bikes. Again, it depends what you have in mind to use them for. In terms of running costs, you know, they're very cheap to run. The servicing costs are to a minimal in comparison to some of certainly the Japanese manufacturers. For example, belt drive on the Harley-Davidson would last probably four or five times longer than chain drive on an imported motorcycle from Japan.
They're big, they're loud, they're different. And if you don't mind Buell-induced backache and numerous recalls, then it's a fun alternative to a sports bike. As for the other big cruisers, if you fancy a burbling V-twin or a V8 for that matter, and cost is no object, then treat yourself. You can guarantee that no one else in your vicinity is going to have one. They are attention-seeker specials.